Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven is not my home, then Lord, what shall I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. So if you miss me, don't come searching. And if you don't find me, you know that I'm gone, gone, gone. If you don't hear from me, don't come knocking, knocking, knocking. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye. If you miss me, don't come searching. And if you don't find me, you know that I'm gone, gone, gone. If you don't hear from me, don't come knocking, knocking, knocking. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye.
It has not been an easy journey. Praise God, I'm almost at the end of year one. To God be the glory, somebody. Praise God, and the Lord brought me through. Hallelujah. One more thing, I've been running from ministry and all of these things. When I got assistant prayer coordinator, in year one, I got assistant. They had a meeting, they selected me without my consent, came to the thing, and they said, "Thank you, your assistant prayer coordinator." I'm like, okay. But anyhow, saints of God, I said, all right, Jesus. And I did what I was supposed to do, but to God be the glory. I'm happy, hallelujah, and I'm blessed that I was able to impact somebody, saints of God. And last week we had, because most of our fourth years in UCAM, they are stepping out now, their time at college is done, so they had the nomination for everything. And saints of God, I'm not glorifying myself. I give all glory to God, because believe you me, I do not want this position. I'm being honest, leadership is not easy. And the only nominee for president that everybody nominated was Tandy. Praise God. And humanly, I told them no, but the Lord showed me a vision the night before that I was going to be the president. I was like, no, God. But saints of God, I'm asking you to pray for me, because it is not an easy one, saints of God, trying to remain saved in college. It is not easy. So I'm asking, when you don't see me, I'm in college, just stretch your hand and say, "Sister, thank you, Jesus." Praise God.
And we are so grateful to be a part of the family of God. We baptize in the name of Jesus, as the Bible teaches. We believe in the infilling of the Holy Ghost power. And we believe that it's the Holy Ghost that's going to quit in this mortal body, so we can make it in one day. Somebody worship the Lord in the house today. Praise the Lord Jesus. See, sometimes you may be going through, but all you need to do is to step out of yourself just a little and just allow the Lord to take over, and you'll be amazed to see what can happen in the house. Praise the Lord, somebody. Bless God. In our midst today, we have this family. Sister Cynthia Walker, Leonie Walker, Akila Faulkner, Miguel Faulkner, and they are from Providence Heights. Praise God. Can I see you standing? Bless the Lord Jesus. Put your hands together for them. So good to have you. So good to have you worshiping with us today. The Lord bless you. Please do come again. God bless you. Somebody please greet them in the name of Jesus. We have Ruth and Curtis Ogilvy.
Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Yes, I remember you guys. God bless you. Richly praise Him. And we have Nastasia Parsons. Okay, that's sister. Tasha's sister. And that's our niece as well. Yes, we can see the resemblance. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. Praise God. We have also Daphne Williams in the house. Sister Daphne, where are you? Bless the Lord, Sister Daphne. God bless you. All right, now we have, this is like another family, Kenisha Martin, Sheldon Johnson, Nisha Lee Johnson, and Mabel, another little Johnson. The name started with him and you're Johnson, praise God. Somebody help me, that's the family. I see a lot of
offering. Help me, tell me, please. Tell me your name. Can't hear it.
Michaela.
Mahaley, all right, Mahaley, that's a pretty name. Can I have that family standing and just give a shout to the Lord, please? Open them out and do it together. One, two.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, Lord, bless you, praise God. Benista, Benista, praise God. Mac, Marlin. Oh, Denise, God bless you. So good to have you as well. God bless you. Denicia Taylor. The Lord bless you, Sister Taylor. Praise God. We're also having some visitors here, right beside Sister Williamson. We don't have your name, but we're going to ask you just to stand, wave your hands with us. Praise God. Yes? Yes, just wave your hands if you want to do that. Praise God. Please ask you to support them. Somebody please shake their hands. Really good to have you in our midst. Praise the Lord Jesus. If I'm missing anyone, oh, Sister Sonia Donaldson, she was baptized here and she was having some work issues, so she has not been here for a while, but I'm so happy to see her today. Thanks so they can see you. This is the daughter of Sister Suemi, Sister Anne-Marie's daughter. Praise God. We are happy to have you today. We pray that the Lord will do something about that job so that she'll get the chance to come to church.
When I was in bondage, I just could seem to break free. You know what I know? When I get down on my knees and pray to the Lord, and He delivered me. Now if I do His head and lift my hands up, yes, Lord, I know the Lord will fix it for me. You know, I want to do that verse another time. Hallelujah. When I was in bondage, I just couldn't seem to break free. You know what I do? But I get down on my knees and pray to the Lord, and He delivered me. Now if I, yes, Lord, and live by His commands, and live by, if you believe that the Lord can fix it, the Lord will fix it. No matter what you're going through, the Lord will fix it. Will fix it. I know the Lord will fix it for me.
Get us out of darkness. Those of us who knew nothing about God, those of us who were far from God, look at the fact that now we find ourselves walking in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Is the church with me? Praise God. Now, as to children of God, as the followers of Christ, there are some aspects of Jesus' life that all of us are going to have to go through when we are saved. I've said it before that there are three aspects of Jesus' life, and the first time I preached it without understanding fully what it really meant until I had to experience it for myself, because there are times when we can testify, there are times when we can sing songs, there are times when we can preach messages, and the reality is we have not experienced it for ourselves. Are you with me, somebody? Sometimes we testify, and we testify about Paul, Peter, and some of the apostles, but we have not gone through what Paul, Peter, and the rest of them have been through. But then there comes a time when God allows you to have your own experience. Is the church with me? Praise God. The first aspect of Jesus' life that we have to understand is that He went through a period of obscurity. In that Jesus, there was a time when nobody knew about Jesus. There was a time when nobody knew who He was. years, and there's about some years of Jesus' life from when he was 12 to when he was 30 years old that nobody knew about. It was his period of obscurity. Nobody knew him. Nobody knew his greatness. Nobody knew what the purpose that he came for or what he was able to do. And then there came another period in Jesus' life, which was his period of popularity, when he came on the scene and everyone wanted to be associated with him. Everybody wanted to be one of Jesus' disciples. And he came to a point that Jesus got so popular that the Bible said that while he was entering into Jerusalem, that they broke down palm leaves and they took off their robes and they laid it on the ground, and Jesus, riding on a donkey, rode on their robes and on palm leaves, and they said, "Hosanna, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord." And so they praised him, they hailed him as being king, and everybody wanted to be associated with Jesus. But then that brings us to the third aspect of Jesus' life that we're all going to have to go through, and that is the period of rejection. Are you with me, somebody? Because Jesus was praised today and he was hailed today. God Almighty, but a few days later, the very mouths that shouted Hosanna were now shouting, "Crucify him." Are you with me, somebody? The same mouth that said, "Hosanna, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord." It was the same mouth that said, "Give us Barabbas and crucify Jesus." Can I talk to the church? You are called by God, but there is a time and a process before God unveils who you are. And in that period of time, it's not that you couldn't sing, it's not that you couldn't preach, it's not that you couldn't pray, it's not that you were not gifted, but there was not the time. It was just not the time for God to unveil that which he placed in you. Are you with me, somebody? And if we move too fast, then we can and miss our time. And so Jesus was not yet ready to be revealed. And his mother said, "Son, there is no wine." Jesus said to his mother, "Woman, what have I to do with you? Because my time is not yet come." Are you with me, somebody? And in the period of obscurity, it's when you're in the back corner, it's when you're at the backside of the mountain, it's when you're there taking care of some sheep, and nobody bothered to call you to say there is an anointing about to be done here today. Y'all know David. I have some Davids in the house. David, which nobody even bothered to call you to say, "David, there is a priest coming today." Are you with somebody? But then God has a way of just breaking off the veil. God has a way of just busting yours and letting you step in. And all those who didn't know you could sing and not be blessed by your voice. Are you with me, somebody? All those who didn't know you could pray and not asking you, "Son, sister, or brother, come and pray for me." All those who didn't know that the gift of was upon you and now asking you to lay your hands upon them. Are you with me, somebody? When God removes the veil, he's gonna exalt you, he's gonna lift you up, he's gonna extend all you. There's some of you who have never been in as much as a Knoxford bus. Am I talking to somebody? Only thing you know, a taxi, or you're with me somebody. But God is getting ready to let you step on that aeroplane. Are you with me, church? God is getting ready to move you from country to country. Are you with me, somebody? He's getting ready to move you to higher heights and deeper depths. But can I caution somebody that in your period of God exhorting you, there is something else that you should look for? All them folks that stands with you and says, sister, you can sing good and you bless my heart. All those who said, preacher, you can preach. All those who said, sister, you can direct. All those who said, brother, you can play the keyboard. There's coming a time when all those that are with you are going to be against you. I just put me somebody. There is a period of rejection that will come in the shine of God's life. But when that comes, one has to understand that Jesus, when he felt the rejection, what do you do when you're anointed but rejected? What do you do when you're called of God and anointed but you're put at the backside? Jesus said, if it be possible, let this go pass. Nevertheless, not as I will. So irrespective of the fact that I may be rejected, guess what? I'm still anointed. Irrespective of the fact that I may be rejected, I still got a voice to sing. So every time I get the chance to sing, I'm still gonna sing. If you're just sick in the house, you might not have called me to lay my hands on you, but guess what? The gift is still in me. I'm still gonna lay my hands. I'm still gonna testify. I'm still gonna preach. I'm still gonna magnify the Lord, because I know who I am. I know who called me. And if he called me, then I know he'll bring me through the muck and the mire. If he called me, I know he stands with me when I'm going through the fiery furnace. I heard the word say, when you go through the fires, it shall not kindle against your flesh. Do I have a believer in the house? He said, when you go through the waters, it's shall not overflow you. Somebody ask a question. Whose reports will you believe? I will believe the report of the Lord. His reports say I am filled. His reports say I am saved. His reports say I am sanctified. Somebody open up your mouth and give God glory. Up in here.
Watch this.
God. It's just amazing to see sometimes how people expect to see you fail.
Amen.
And the more they expect to see you go down,
yes,
is the more God gives you.
Yes.
My haters, can I just speak to you today? God bless you. Without you, I would not have been where I am today. My God Almighty, without you, I would not be able to witness to the amount of people that I'm able to witness to. Without you, I would not be able to counsel people the way that I'm called. God bless you, haters. My God. God bless you, haters. Watch this. And these are for me young people then. And everybody can relate to this one. The Lord say, you don't love me. The Lord say, you don't like me. But you have to live with me. How all the young people are going to relate to that? You have to live with me. Oh, you still have to live with me because God called me, anointed me, and appointed me.
Say God, you turn a mess into a message. Now the messenger arrived. Committed to the journey, so me now go backslide. Looking through the spirit and the physical eyes. Ooh, to God me testify. Know me are the worker, God are the boss. My whole life, he endorsed. Take me from the mud and put me in a A-class.